Come. इत्थं मांसमीमांसया
प्रथितं स्वायुः अलं नयन्ति एते येन एड कृत्वा जीवन्ति एड तथा येन व्यवहृति पटवः एड भवन्ति एड तथा येन सौभाग्यभाजः एड भवन्ति तं अंतर्गतं प्राणाधीशं अमृतं अमुं नैव मीमांसयन्ति.
In the earlier verse, the contrast between Atma and our body was drawn. In the third verse, the word Atma was used just like that without describing what Atma is. In the fourth verse, in the very beginning, it was pointed out that Atma is Chit with Sukha. Sukhatma means Sukha Sarupa. Chit with Sukha Sarupa. And we have seen that in this context, because the Vit is used, Chit stands for Sat, ever existence principle. So therefore, Chit with Sukhatma means Chit with Sukha Swarupa means Sat Chit Ananda Swarupa. Fine? This is the nature of Atma. And what is that Atma? Whatever we refer to as I, that I must be this Atma. But we commit the universal mistake of taking the body as Atma. Now, what is the nature of the body? Inside, outside, already told. Asti, Snayu, Madhya, Pala, Rudhira, Vasa, Charma, Medha, etc. Inside, Vit, Mutra, Shleshma, Purna, all these things. Now, you have got a yardstick of what Atma is. What is the yardstick of Atma? It should be Sat, ever existing principle, applied to the body. What is Sat? That which always exists. Does the body always exist? No. Body has got birth, body has got death. Out. Body is not Sat, which is referred to here as Chit. Then, is the body knowledgeable? Can the body get knowledge on its own? No. See, you compare a dead body with a living person. If Chit, that is with that knowledge principle where the intrinsic feature of the physical body also should know, dead person will see, oh, relatives are crying, what a pity, they are crying, I have to go, they are remaining here. Who will do the dead person? Because with knowledge principle, intrinsic feature, it is not so. At least you know for certain your body is inert. By its own. So therefore, this also is ruled out. Me, it cannot be. Ananda, don't ask at all. We know what is the plight of the body. We know what is the plight of the body. Ever source of sorrow. Now come on, you tell me. This body, can it be Sachidananda? And what do you do? What do? You take that body as Aho. For us no Aho. It's taken for granted. we are taken granted to majority of the universal reward. Body is taken as Shankaracharya, the oldest person, he doesn't know internet and email, how to send email and all. WhatsApp, he doesn't know. So we can't take them seriously. Even Krishna, we can't take seriously. Ask Krishna, does he know what's up? So does he know what's up? So we can't take them seriously. We are mortal people. Is it? Can you put this to vote? Because what he said is, what is that in the Vedas? That is aho. This aho is not over yet. This further matters. See what blunders they are being done. And the result, what happens is, Atma Jnana appears to be very, 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 very difficult in spite of being whatever that I is itself is what? Satchit Sukha. Yes, sir. How many years you are attending to? At least by the little inkling, I am Satchidananda Swarupa. Even a simple discipline, don't talk in the satsang hall and the dining hall, cannot be followed. I have got the list of those who talk, okay? I have got this. Next time I will make it a point while enrolling. It's become just a nature. And unfortunately, the most poor student who are attending my classes and this camps for decades, new people behave properly. It's so big. You are not aware of it, where you are taking for granted. It should not be. Anyway, so now, after so many years of exposure to Vedanta, so we are still not able to discover that I am Satchidananda Swarupa. What does it mean? Some obstruction is there, some pratibandha is there, very, very, very powerful, which keeps us preoccupied in the things which are not conducive to know Atma Swarupa. On the contrary, which are hostile to know Atma Swarupa. So what are those? Let us see now. Fifth stanza. Atma Jnana se durlabhatvam. Atma Jnana is very difficult to get. Now see. And with this Atma? Eyes. Atma being myself, its knowledge is very difficult to get. Means we are preoccupied in the things which we are not supposed to. Means our judgment is wrong. Our priorities are wrong. Our value structures are wrong. So we have to set them right. Then only we will be able to eligible to directly cognize the Atma Swarupa. Says, now listen. Ami sarve loka. All these people, see, sarve loka. Sarve loka, what does it mean? All people, maybe exception. Maybe one or two exception like Adi Shankaracharya, Gaudapada Acharya, Vashishta, Vamadeva, few examples, but almost all people. Ami sarve loka. What do they do? Iha. Iha means iha loke. In this world, see, you should be very careful with iha, etc. Iha means where? Here. Patra means here. But he want that here, you have to verify. In this world, in this world means which world? Manushya loka. What about the heavens, etc.? In heavens, etc., you have no freedom. Freedom of choice. In human embodiment, you have a freedom of choice. You have a limited free will to take to this way or that way. other embodiments are heavenly or hellish, where you are totally programmed. You have no free will. You can't have a choice. They are called bhoga bhumis. Only you can experience, eke out your karma phalas, good in heaven, bad in heaven. They are called bhoga. But human embodiment, this earth, especially the human embodiment, is karma bhumi beside bhoga. Means you have got a free will to do. But it is not total free will. Within a circumscribed limit, for example, a cow is tied with a rope and other end of the rope is tied to a tree. Cow has limited freedom. It can move freely in the world. A circle with the radius as the length of the rope. Like that, as a human being, iha means this human embodiment where free will is there, one can either make oneself or one can damn oneself. So this is that, there what is that? Iha, in this loka, what they do? These are the things which give me happiness and they are totally preoccupied in this. Their concept is, see, one thing is sure, everyone wants to be happy or not. Everyone wants to live for long or not. Everyone wants to know everything or not. Now they think it can be pursued by this. What are those pursuits? Deha, body, so body, stri, woman, wife, husband, putra, son, children, mitra, friends, anuchara, servants, haya, horses, nowadays Mercedes, Audi, and all those Skoda, so all those vehicles, let us, Vrishaha, bulls in the sense of cattle, wealth. So we can add a long list. What is that? TV, WhatsApp. I'm not joking, I'm updating because these were not there on those days. Now see, if WhatsApp, face, internet is not available, life of some people is totally miserable. How much dependence? At least depending on a cup of tea or coffee can understand, can be understood. But dependence on the what? WhatsApp and Facebook, think of it. Why? Even while walking, I find these people are samadhis. You see their face, they're lost somewhere. Well, and then I thought, I said, what? There is one earful. There is one earful. Sometimes I'm there, they're laughing. on the road, laughing, talking to someone. See how much? They want something, some music or something, don't you think? Dependence on. More you depend, more you invite sorrows. Rule. More you depend, more sorrows you invite. Least dependence must be to such an extent you don't depend on the very body itself. Which body? Our body. Can you do it now? Can you be independent of the body now? Come on, tell me, why not? Prarabdha is over and body will be over. Why you want the body? What for this human embodiment is meant? Not heavenly and hellish. What for the human embodiment? For purusharthas. Artha, kama, dharma, moksha. So when these purusharthas will end, when they are discovered, moksha, your sarupa, until that, artha, kama, dharma will continue. Can you say, I don't need body? No, you have to depend on the body. So, once the atma-jnana is gained, moksha is gained, my sarupa directly cognized, there is no purusharta, therefore what? You can show your thumb even to the body. Not bad. Thank you. Goodbye. You can be. You have to be. See, if you have got atma-jnana, first consideration will be attitude of gratitude towards all entire world, including the thank you all. So you have made me discover what my sarupa, including my number one enemy. Because if he has not pestered, I would not have taken to. See, when the brahmacharis in the ashram, Puja Swami used to say, if I see the horoscope of you people all, Shani must be in this place. Otherwise, you will not land here at all. Otherwise, you are not going to land. So that Shani should be thanked or not. So which directed you? You are the person, enemy who was giving me trouble. So it made me think, etc. Is this world worthwhile pursuing or discover sarupa? Should have gratitude towards them. So that is there is a. So but presently what is the concept? See that no independence. These all. Any more list can be added depending on the time and place. So, mama tosha hetu. Mama tosha hetu. Hetu means. These are the means of my happiness. Ittam means with such notion. Come on, yes or no?
Yes.
Tell me, true or not?
Yes.
Is it not? That is why we are deprived of our wrong notion. Wrong notion. Ittam. So, with such a notion, and then what? Identification, not only identification, total preoccupation. So, total preoccupation. In projection in what? Deha, Stri, Putra, Mitra, Anuchara, all these lists. What is that preoccupation? First thing is what? And how? See, look here. If something good happens, in all that we depend, we are happy. If something bad happens, in those things we depend, we are unhappy. We are dependent on the conditions of what? Those all things which are considered as the means of our happiness. Is it not? Putre pushte aham pushta. Putre nashte aham nashta. So the son is doing well, I am very happy. Son is suffering, I am unhappy. In the KG class, son got 60% KG class, okay. These parents are totally unhappy. In the KG class, he got 95%. Ha! KG, okay, not PhD. So much of identification. So that is there. So our sorrow depends on that. Then, sasbharana, protection, poshana, sustenance, all these, are we occupied or not? service. So therefore, ittham, what they do? They mamsa mimamsaya. Here mimamsa means inquiry, vichara. Mamsa mimamsaya, beautiful word. All they are preoccupied in the matters related to flesh. Mamsa mimamsaya means mamsa mimamsaya means vicharayanti, that they think and they get preoccupied. As a result, what they do? Prathitam swayuhu alabdayanti. With this attitude, with this value structure, with these notions, what they do? Prathitam aswayuhu, their precious life, swayuhu life. Prathitam means literally celebrated. Celebrated means very precious. Which life they spend their life? Which life? Shatashloki is taught to whom? To? Cows? Horses? Bulls? Human beings. Sure? Why? Human being is the eligible entity to gain the knowledge. Prathitam ayuhu, this human life. Do you know, human life is meant only for gaining this knowledge. Other bhogas you can go with other embodiment. That is why in the very beginning, Adi Shankaracharya in Vivek Chudamani says, Jantuna Narajanma Durlabham. Among all embodiments, human body is very difficult to get. Yena kena prakarena, by any means whatsoever, have you got a human embodiment? Yes or no?
Yes.
Any doubt? Then what purpose you have to make use of it? For the purpose for which it is designed, is it not? It is designed to gain Atma Jnana Brahma Jnana. Because we have got faculty of intellect. Buddhi, intellect, is the prerogative of human embodiment. It is this human embodiment alone you can take to Viveka. What is the real purpose of life? What is the real happiness which you can do Viveka where? In the human embodiment. Other embodiments are aware, they are seen, they are programmed. They are programmed. So therefore, even denizens of heaven are what? They would like to gain the human embodiment. And we, having got the human embodiment, waste in the other pursuit. Which pursuit? Dehastri Mutta Pitra. That phrase keep in the. So therefore, this Durlava Narajanma, they just scatter, they just waste in other pursuit. And how? Alam Nayati. Alam means totally. See, alam means generally enough. While eating, etc., enough. That is what is called as what? Alam. So it also means totally. Totally 24/7 what pursuit? Deha, Sri, Buddha, Putra, Mitra, Anuchara, Aya, Vrisha, Tosha, Hindu. In this only. Now, the question is, why they do it? Why they means who? We are also. In fact, we are the why do we do it? Do they not know the highest good for them? No. He says, Shankaracharya consoles you. Don't worry. It is not your mistake. It is mistake that you are ignorant. Because of ignorance, it is done only to point out remedy is what? Knowledge. This is because of lack of ascertainment of the final goal of life, even after being born as a human being. Human embodiment is not meant for khao, piyo, maja karo. Khao, piyo, maja karo. There are better embodiments for khana, pina, maja karma. Suppose a person is a glutton, wants to eat more and more. How much he will eat? But suppose if he is a buffalo belly, or elephant's belly, how much is it? So which is better designed to eat more? Human embodiment or? See, you think that in human embodiment you can get better sense enjoyment. Wrong notion. Your happiness in the party in the 5-star hotel is equal to the piggy who is roasting. Who is rolling in the dirty mire. I'm not joking. You know the incident? Indra got a curse to become a pig. And with piggy children, etc. He was there in the mire and enjoying. Narada was passing. You? Narada detected who? Devendra. What is this flight? Is that end of Narayana, 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 Narayana. Indra, what is this? Do one thing. I will encash my tapobala to redeem you from this pig embodiment. So Devendra said, Narada, why you interfere in my why you interfere? I'm so happy. That is what I said. Your happiness in the 5-star hotel is equal to this. What a great deal is. See, here you have to spend so much of money and all that. To spend these hours in the 5-star hotel, you are slogging for days together to earn that money. And this one, bina paisa, bina bank account. Think. That's what it is. So therefore, see, the question is, why they do it? It is due to ignorance. So that ignorance has to be eliminated. That will say, ete means, this deha stri putradaya. So what they do, what they want to do, vichara, they don't do. Which Mimamsa they have to take to, they don't take to. And where Mimamsa should not be taken, they take to. Right opposite. So what is that? Really speaking, they should have inquired about this. What is it? Says, ete, deha, stri, putra, mitra, anuchara, etc. Vichar, the means of my happiness, these, yena krutva, on account of what factor, on account of what principle, on account of what entity. See, jivanti, live, See, do you want Deha Putra Mitra also or not? Find out on account of what they are living. If they are not living, are they useful to you? No. Now, what is that basis which makes them live? So, Jivanti, so also, Tatha, Yena, because of which principle, because of which entity, Vyavahruti Pratavaha Bhavanti. All these Deha, Putra, Mitra, Kalatra, Haya, Vrisha, etc. become skillful, efficient in their vyavahara, in their functioning. Vyavahruti Patavaha. Vyavahruti is vyavahara. They are capable of taking to vyavahara, dealings, interact with the world. So, on account of what are they able to interact in the world? Not only that, tatha, so also, yena, so that means yena because of which factor, so what happens? Saubhagya bhajaha bhavanti, they become beautiful. Deha, your embodiment, is beautiful because of Stri, Putra, Mitra, beautiful because of. Beautiful means not necessarily that you have to be Miss World or Miss India or not that way. You want everyone's body is beautiful. Beauty is a concept. So they say in Kannada one statement is that. Hetta taige heggana buddho. To the mother who has delivered the child, even the rat is what? Very cute. For everyone, the wife and husband are most beautiful. Don't ask others, okay? But they are most beautiful. It's a concept. So there is a. So. Saubhagya, not that way. If you want to find out everybody is beautiful, you know what you do? Visit some morgue. In morgue, the bodies are kept in the air conditioned, this thing. Suppose a body gets decomposed. Would you be able to look at the sight of it? So disgusting. That is the nature of our body. But presently, packing is pakka. What packing? Skin packing. So there is a glow on the face. Maybe beautiful or ugly, but there is a glow on the face. For example, Vyasa. Vyasa was the most ugly person to look at. But that power of knowledge was such that in his eyes there was glow, full aravindaksha. So like the eyes like that means lotus petal. So that means what happens? What is this principle which makes this body what? Beautiful. Beautiful means worthy of handling, worthy of making use of. Saubhagya bhajaha bhavanti. That is what? Tam. Means that principle. Who is the antargatam? Abiding in and through all of them. Antargatam pranadhisham. One who is adhisha, overlord, master of prana. See, look, one thing you'll agree. For all of us to live, pranas are required or not? No, chale? Chale gaya. Kya chale gaya? Prana chale gaya. What does it mean? person is dead. So that means at least this much is true. The pranas, the vital air, the physiological functions keep this body intact. Now, on account of what principle the pranas function? Because pranas are inert in nature. Pranas are product of your food. They are inert, but they are able to function in a particular way. Prana desham. And what is its nature? Amrutam. Indestructible. Never perishable. Amum. This principle. What now? Tell me, what is that principle? Because of which all of us live, we are able to interact with the world. We are beautiful. So, and who is the master of the pranas? Who is not subject to destruction? Can you tell me from the earlier verse what is that principle? Chitvit sukham. Satchit anandam. What is it? Atmananda. What they do? Ayo. Naiva mimamsayanti. Naiva vicharayanti. Don't inquire into it. See, my swarupa is Satchidananda. This body can never be I, Satchidananda. Not only that, the nature of the body is totally in contrast with what I, Satchidananda, is. In spite of that, we take that embodiment as I. And we think our happiness is on account of Deha, Stri, Putra, Mitra, etc., 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 etc. And we are totally preoccupied in the pursuit of these. And the result, what happens? We live or spend our life in such a way that we never care to inquire on account of which principle the indispensable entities for my happiness in terms of Deha, Stri, Putra, Mitra, etc. live, on account of which they are able to interact with the world, on account of which they are beautiful, on account of which prana, which is indispensable, is able to function. Naiva mimamsa. Who is superior? Who can give you the happiness? Keep in mind, our pursuit is what? Live forever. Freedom from ignorance. Happiness all along. Totally free from the least trace of sorrow. Now tell me, where is it? Which camp you will get now? Not Lodavada camp, etc. Okay? Whether Chitvit Sukha camp or that is what? This Vapu, what is Asti, Snayu, etc. Which camp you will get it? You decide. But mere decision and making a note will not help. Your acharana, further pursuit must be to discover directly this Swarupa. So therefore, our preoccupation is such that it totally denies us the pursuit of discovering directly our Swarupa, which is, as described here, chit with sukha, meaning sat chit ananda. How to begin with? Change your value structure. Re-evaluate. You know, examination papers are re-evaluated. There are certain universities. The re-evaluation gets the third time also. I don't know all universities. Puttaparthi University, Satyasai University. Answer papers are evaluated by the university staff. And they send the question papers to some other university, different universities. And when they come, if difference is about 20%, they send for the third time evaluation. So you do at least one evaluation of what? The pursuit that we are preoccupied. Don't give me reasons, this, etc., as if you are the Ishwara, you are going to set right the world and all that. Forget about that. Bhagavan is there for that. When dharma crumbles, who can set it right? Even sages can't do that. For example, see, there is a long bridge on the highway. And the bridge has got collapsed. However enthusiastic these villagers may be, can they set right? Can they repair the bridge? Who has to come? The authority who has constructed the bridge has to come. Do that. So like that, who established dharma? Ishwara. So when dharma has crumbled as now, who are you to take the entire burden on your head just to waste your life with all arguments? Pray. How? It is his job, not our job. So that means what? Wrong evaluation. Wrong evaluation. So he is capable, you know that word is samartha. Parameshwar samartha. You don't dictate that this, it should be this way, it should be that way, etc. Who are you telling? What is the samartha? Capable of doing anything. You know, in Maharashtra there is one saint, Samartha Ramdas. You know how this word samartha came? See, Ramdas was wearing a kaupina and he was very beautiful and all that, robust and strong and all that, fair complexion. He was a great Rama Bhakta to the extent he was always carrying bow and arrow and in a kaupina. He was passing through Godavari, Nasik area, Godavari. On the Godavari river he was passing. Some Brahmins were taking bath in the Godavari river. They found this person cannot be a hunter because there is a glow on his face. He cannot be a hunter. He is a very great, noble person. But why should he carry bow and arrow? So they thought of a little ridicule. Hey, do you know how to shoot an arrow? Bagai Saika. Put it like this. He took the bow and arrow, shot a bird. Bird fell down. The Brahmin said, idiot, only for the sake of error, killing an innocent bird. He went, he picked up the bird, clasped the brother's bosom. Oh Rama, if my devotion is true, please save the bird. Within no time, the birds started fluttering and said, these Brahmins are aghast. Are Baba, manto tula. And that is Sashtanga Namata. You are really Samartha. Samartha means capable. Have the Shraddha in Parameshwara. Don't question his modus operandi. He will take care of the world. You are none to do that. If you try to do that, you will ruin yourself. So that is what. So he has got his own way. So that is. For example, Krishna was avatar, we accept or not. Now, just reconsider few episodes in Mahabharata time. First of all, see who Krishna is such a capable and see chami chami with whom? Pandavas. See, how did he allow the Draupadi to be abducted? Why did he allow Draupadi to be humiliated? He saved afterwards, humiliated her. Why could he not save his own nephew Abhimanyu? Why his what? Pandavas had to suffer where? In forest and Ajnatavasa. Who? All the time Krishna rubbing shoulder to shoulder with whom? Many incidents you can question. No, we don't. But finally they said, he was bent upon that. He was bent upon what? Establishing the dharma. That's what he said. Actually, only two persons could have ever read Mahabharata war. Number one was Dhritarashtra. But he wanted the Duryodhana to be the king. Number two was who? Krishna. Krishna said, I will not forgive Duryodhana. I will show the possibility that such adharma will never be tolerated. Yes, what is worth it? We can't question. But many things can be questioned. We don't question because we know for certain. Likewise, the present age also, there is a power that is going to set it right, but it is in its own ways. So best thing is, get guided by the Shastra, take care of your interest. Ishvara doesn't need assistance. I had a student, a Parsi student. He said, why Ishvara should do like this? Why Ishvara should not do that? I said, tell, look here, he doesn't need assistant, he will give advertisement that I need assistant. So leave it to him. He is what? Samartha. Have that firm conviction. Mind your highest good. No time to waste your time in other things. This world is going to be like that only. It is like continuous streamness. So, but in spite of all this, the Shastra says, discover your Swarupa. So therefore what they do, that principle, what is it? Chitvit sukha sachidananda naiva mimasayanti naiva vicharayanti. Don't inquire. What they do? Flesh inquiry. See, I have not added one thing there. Deha, stri, putra, mitra, Facebook, all the property I have. Property, bank balance and all those I have not added there. So then what comes? Property. See, Satya Sai Baba says, properties are not propertized. Think of it. Properties are not proper. Nowadays, real estate. That real estate, what a mithya estate, you don't know. It can be mithya. Real estate. All mass media, bakras are there. Real estate. So properties, all it upalakshana. You can write a thesis on what are the things which are not, we should not put our brain in, we are putting our brain with the concept that what? They will make me happy. In fact, what they have to discover is Atma Mimamsa they should do, Na Mimamsa Yanti. So now he says, this Atma and embodiment, in the case of ignorant person, how they are interdependent. In the case of who? Ignorant person. With that ignorant person, what we call him? Jiva. In the case of ignorant person, Jiva, this embodiment and this Atma, how they are independent. Let us see.
Kaschit kita kathanchit patumati ravita kantakanam kutiram.
Kaschit kita kathanchit patumati ravita kantakanam kutiram.
Kurvanste naiva sakam vyavaruti vidhaye cheshtate yavadayuh.
Kurvanste naiva sakam vyavaruti vidhaye.
Tadva jivo चरित समुदितै कर्म भिस्थूल देहम्
जीवो विना चरित समुदितै कर्म भिस्थूल देहम्
निर्मायात्रैव तिष्ठन्ननुदिनममुना साकमभ्येति भूमौ
निर्मायात्रैव तिष्ठन्ननुदिनममुना साकमभ्येति भूमौ
कश्चित् कीटः कथञ्चित् पटुमतिरभित कण्टकानां कुटीरम्
कश्चित् कीटः कथञ्चित् पटुमतिरभित कण्टकानां कुटीरम्
कुर्वन्स्तेनैव साकं व्यवरुति विधये चेष्टते यावदायुः
कुर्वन्स्तेनैव साकं व्यवरुति विधये
तद्वज्जीवोऽपि नानाचरितसमुदितैः कर्मभिः स्थूलदेहम्
तद्वज्जीवोऽपि नानाचरितसमुदितैः कर्मभिः स्थूलदेहम्
निर्मायात्रैव तिष्ठन्ननुदिनममुना साकमभ्येति भूमौ
निर्मायात्रैव तिष्ठन्ननुदिनममुना साकमभ्येति भूमौ
अन्वय कश्चित् पटुमतिः कीटः कथञ्चित् कण्टकानां कुटीरम् अभितः कुर्वन् व्यवहृतिविधये तेन एव साकं यावद् आयुः चेष्टते तद्वत् जीवः अपि नानाचरितसमुदितैः कर्मभिः स्थूलदेहं निर्माय ततः अत्र एव तिष्ठन् अमुना साकम् अनुदिनं भूमौ अभ्येति
सेकेण्ड्
अन्वय अगेन् कश्चित् पटुमतिः कीटः कथञ्चित् कण्टकानां कुटीरम् अभितः कुर्वन् व्यवरुतिविधये तेन एव साकं यावद् आयुः चेष्टते तद्वत् जीवः अपि नानाचरितसमुदितैः कर्मभिः स्थूलदेहं निर्माय ततः अत्र एव तिष्ठन् अमुना साकम् अनुदिनं भूमौ अभ्येति
कश्चित् कीटः कीटः मीन्स् लिटरलि इन्सेक्ट् देयर इट् केन् मीन् स्पैडर् ओर् वी केन् टेक् ए बर्ड् कश्चित् कीटः सम् इन्सेक्ट् ओर् ए बर्ड् दट् इस् स्पैडर् ओर् ए बर्ड् And what is its nature? Patumatihi. Patumati means clever-minded, skillful. Patumatihi, clever minded, skillful. What does it do? So, kashchit patumatihi kitaha. Kashchit patumatihi kitaha. What does it do? Kathanchit. Somehow, it is not just somehow, it knows the knack, it knows the method. What does it do? Kantakanam kutiram abhitaha kurvan. Kutira. Kutira can mean here cobweb or nest. If you take the spider, it is a cobweb. If you take the bird, it is nest. See, now a spider weaves the web from where? Saliva. The threads born of saliva are described as kantaka. Kantaka means like thorn in the sense, slim, etc., reeds, etc. Kantakana kutira. Fine, it does it create or not? So how much, which training school it went to learn the weaving the web? Again, bird. Have you seen the birds forming the nest? Not ordinary nest. Have you seen sometimes in the railway track, you know, some nests are inverted, hanging down, like the pipe of the snake charmer. You know why it is? When it lays the eggs, the snake should not enter. If the opening is on the top, they will enter. The snake cannot go down and then go up. It can't. See, skillful or not. And after getting that grass, this, etc., which architectural quality it had got? Skillful or not. And then what they do? See, so that was Kurvan. Kutiram Kurvan. Vyavahruti Vishaye. Vyavahruti Vishaye. In the matters of vyavahara, dealing with the world for their own purpose, tena eva sakam, sakam means saha, together with that cobweb or with that nest, together with that nest, what they do? Yavadayuhu cheshtate. Whole life they what? Spend with the help of what? This web or the nest. Can it survive without it? No. It has totally depend on them. Accepted? We also do the same thing. How? Let us see. Tadvat. In same manner. Jiva api. Even this individual entity, jiva. We give a con, draw the contrast between Atma and Jiva. You also we call I, Atma also we call I. In fact, Jiva in reality is I. I, Atma, conditioned by gross body, subtle body, causal body, ignorance is who? Samsari, Sukha Dukha Atmaka, Jiva. Strip off from this conditioning upadis is nothing but Chaitanya Sarupa Atma. The Jiva, the individual entity, Nana Charita Samuditaihi Karmabihi Sthula Deham Nirmaya. Nirmaya, having created what? Sthula Deha. So they mean this present physical body. What is the, there it was Kantaka. The saliva or the reeds, etc., twigs, etc., it was there. Here what is that? Nana Charita Samuditaihi Karmabhi. By karma, which karmas? Prarabdha karma. Which karmas? Prarabdha karma. So how did it earn it? In the past, Nana Charita Samuditaihi. That is, it is earned through different types of actions performed in the past. So the sthula deham nirmaya, nirmaya, having created what happens tataha, thereafter, atraiva, in this embodiment only, sthula only, tishtan, remaining, identifying with that embodiment, amuna sakam, with this amuna means dehena, with this embodiment, dehena amuna, dehena sakam saha, what does it do? Amuna sakam, anudinam bhumau abhedi, every day he roams where? On this today Bombay, tomorrow Delhi, day after tomorrow Moscow, after that New York, then Melbourne, roams about the world. Means that, or Lonavada, he roams about the world. On the Sakam of Devi. Now see the dependence. For the bird, nest is required. For nest, who is required? Bird. For jiva, body is required. For body to operate on the world, who is required? Jiva is required. Mutual dependence. Mutual dependence. So that means, see, for example, a car without a driver can't move. So also, the body without the jiva cannot. A driver without the vehicle can't drive. Jiva without the vehicle of body cannot interact with the world. Mutual dependence or not? All for what? Tosha hetu, verse 5. To eke out the happiness through the means which we consider as the means of earning happiness, that without inquiring because of whom these means of happiness are able to survive, interact with the world, are beautiful, and even that one who is the adhisha of the prana, we don't inquire into. So the question is, all you want is what? Sachit with sukha. Why not this deha with chit with sukha? Take this deha, which you already seen earlier, the contrast between this. Body is right opposite to sachit ananda. It can never be sukha. So same thing is explained with the help of an illustration.
Swasti prajavya paribalayanta nyayena margena mahi mahisha o brahmanebhya shubhamastu nityam loka samasta sukhino bhavantu kale varshatu parjanya prithivi sasya shalini desho yam shobharahitah brahmana santu nirbhayah om sarve bhavantu sukhinah sarve santu niramayah sarve bhadrani pasyantu ma kashchit dukha bhag bhave asato ma sargamaya tamaso ma jyotirgamaya mrityorma amrutam gamaya om purnamada purnamidam purnat purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate Om Shanti 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 Hari Om श्री गुरुभ्यो नमः हरिः ओम्।